Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about web security, but we'll keep it simple and focus on what we as a front-end developers can do. Let's start our journey. First is sanitizing form input. Think of your website as a community bulletin board. Just as people pin notes or messages on the board, users on your website input data through forms and comments. We need to carefully check and clean this data to ensure it doesn't contain harmful elements like SQL injections. This is similar to making sure that all nodes on the bulletin board are appropriate and safe, preventing any harmful or malicious messages from being displayed. Next, we discuss sending data safely. This is like sending a letter with a safety seal. When you send data to the backend, use its content time options, no sniff. This slide may ensure your letter can be changed into something harmful, preventing browsers from mistaking a dangerous JavaScript file for something safe. Now let's talk about rate limiting and throttling. Think of it as pacing yourself in a race. We control how often users can ask questions to our APIs, like in search bars. This helps our servers from getting too busy and stops misuse. Then there is HTTPS and data encryption. This is like using a secret language for your messages. HTTPS encrypts data sent to servers, keeping personal information safe. It's like code that only you and the server can understand. However, even with HTTPS, we should avoid sensitive info in URLs. It's like not sharing your secrets where others can hear. Don't put private info like social security numbers in URLs, as they can be easily spotted. Use the request body instead. Next is content security policy. This is like setting house rules for what your family can watch on TV. CSP lets your website load only safe content from places you trust, keeping bad stuff out. Subresource integrity is also important. It's like checking that the ingredients for your meal are exactly what you expect. This makes sure that files, especially JavaScript, from other servers haven't been messed with. Another important aspect, access control allow origin or source. Imagine deciding who can come to a birthday party. It lets you choose who can use your website stuff like images. You might let some sites use them, but not others. Additionally, there is the important step of checking libraries in your project. It's like checking the quality of tools you use for your DI project. Always verify the libraries you add to your project. Make sure they are from reliable sources and they are up to date. This is crucial because outdated or unsafe libraries can be like faulty tools that compromise the integrity of your project. And that's our simple guide to web security. Like heroes in a story, we all have a role in keeping our online world safe. Every little thing we do helps protect our digital space. See you next time. Bye.